Looking for a new or used vehicle? The Auto Channel has dozens of searchable databases with the latest pricing information, in-depth specifications, and tons of reviews, and it's all available free.
Well, good afternoon, everybody. Hey, kids, how are you? You see this car over here? There's a hydrogen cars. No greenhouse gases, no pollution, no global warming with those cars, okay? So that's the future, just so you know. Anyway, it's good to have you all here, and we just want to introduce here another car. As I said, that we will be bringing in here a lot of cars to the capital steps that are green and that will help us with our goal, which is to reduce greenhouse gases in California. As you know, that we have made a commitment in 2006 to roll back our greenhouse gases to the 1990 level and reduce our greenhouse gases by 25% and then an additional 85% by the year 2050. And the only way we're going to accomplish that is if we change the technology of our vehicles. And this is why I've, since the beginning of the year, brought here to the capital all kinds of different cars, from hybrid cars to hydrogen cars, electric cars, alternative fuel, biofuel, and so on. And this is, again, Volkswagen here has this Passat that was used in China during the Olympics. It has zero emissions. It's a hydrogen car, and you will hear more about the actual technology from Anna-Marie Schneider, who is here from Volkswagen. And I just want to congratulate Volkswagen for being out there and stepping up to the plate and meeting our challenges. And this is a partnership that comes from Shanghai, Volkswagen Shanghai, with the Chinese. They're working together on this. And then they're bringing now, I think, 17 over here to California, right?
22.
Or 22, actually, over here to California to test drive them. And then they will be importing them to California. So we're looking forward to that because, like I said, this is the only way we're going to solve our problem. And we want to thank them for bringing those cars out here. They brought them here so that the legislators, they had a meeting with the legislators today, this morning, to talk about their program and to test drive those vehicles. I myself will be test driving again. We'll be driving right out here. And the engines are running right now, and you barely can hear those engines, so they're very quiet. But anyway, I want to have also Anna-Marie Schneider say a few words, please.
Well, thank you, Governor Schwarzenegger. We want to thank you for your unwavering commitment to protecting our environment and securing our energy independence. Our fuel cell vehicles that are here from Beijing are an example of the fact that we share that commitment with you, and we want to bring zero-emission vehicles to the U.S. consumer in the future. Volkswagen has made an $11 billion a year commitment as part of their 2018 strategy to bring sustainable mobility in all forms, in all driving styles, to the United States and to the world. Here in the United States, you know, we're not big players, but we have a commitment to sell 1 million vehicles by 2018, and part of that commitment is to bring advanced powertrains like our TDI clean diesel engine technology, which reduces CO2 emissions significantly and improves fuel economy. Those vehicles are here now. These vehicles represent the future. So, Governor, thank you very much for your commitment, for opening the door. We plan to drive through it, and California is the first stop. So thank you.
Thank you very much. Any questions that you have about this?
What's the government doing for hydrogen fuel stations?
Well, we are a very good question. We have been very aggressive since I've come into office to build hydrogen fueling stations all over the state of California. We started with the first one when I first came into office. Now we have 26, and we have right now plan to build 7 more within the next year and a half. And so we're moving forward with public-private partnerships. And it's very important that, you know, it doesn't cost much to the state because we don't have any extra money right now. But, I mean, this is a big priority for us to make sure that people that have hydrogen cars can find fueling stations all over the state of California. They get a map. Right now, we already have enough fueling stations so they can crisscross California. As a matter of fact, we had a whole fleet of hydrogen cars drive all the way up to Vancouver, to British Columbia, just recently to show that there's already a hydrogen highway all the way up there. There have to be some more fueling stations built on the way up there. But we want to make sure when the Winter Olympics happen in British Columbia that we have a hydrogen highway where hydrogen cars can drive all the way up there without any interruption, and they have fueling stations available.
Governor, I wonder if you could respond to the news that Hummer has been sold to a Chinese company. Is there a market for Hummers in America anymore?
I think that the Hummer, as you know, I've always been a big fan of the Hummer, and but I always have said that since we know that we got to get rid of the big polluting vehicles and cars that drive with very low mileage. I mean, with the you know, the Hummer gets maybe 14 miles per gallon. That is not enough. I think that the times have changed, and we the answer to it is not to change the car, but to change the technology of the engine. So, if that very same Hummer would have a hydrogen engine like this Volkswagen Passat has, then we would have no emissions whatsoever. So I think that they are now working on, as you remember, just last week we had the electric Hummer here, the H3. So that's the direction to go, is to go electric, to go hydrogen, to go hybrid. You know, there's many different ways that we have to experiment. And so I think the key thing is this technology here. And so we have to inspire those companies. I think Hummer now, by it being sold to China, I think that the Chinese will, be within a short period of time, I can guarantee you, make this car that only gets now 15 miles a gallon, will go 30 miles, 40 miles a gallon, and it could very well be, knowing the Chinese, that it will go 100 miles an hour very soon. So I think they will be very aggressive, because I've seen, and we have introduced and talked here about cars, there's car companies over there that have just started literally a year ago, and then they're now producing cars that, you know, electric cars, and they're outselling every other car in China. So there's great, great progress being made over there. So I'm just, I feel saddened about the fact that America has so far fallen behind, and that Detroit, the big automakers that make spectacular cars, but somehow have not kept up with the technology. And I think it is largely because they have been protected by the federal government for too long, rather than the federal government saying, here are the new standards, in 10 years from now, those are the cars you have to produce, otherwise the rest of it will be outlawed. So they haven't really set the standards and really come up with laws to guide them and to show leadership. Now with the Obama administration coming, I think it's the first time where they're going in that direction, where they're copying some of our regulations when it comes to tailpipe emissions standards and so on. Thank you very much. Thank you, and again, thank you to Volkswagen for coming out here and coming up with this great innovative technology. Thank you very much. Thank you all.
Thanks for watching The Auto Channel. For more great automotive information and entertainment, visit theautochannel.com, the Internet's most complete and comprehensive automotive information resource.